Collaborative Learning Circle was founded in 2017 after Dave Wright was honoured with the Collaborative Leader Award by the Institution for Collaborative Working. Immediately after the dinner, Dave said, "It's no use being recognised in this way for what we've done in the past if we don't push forward and use it as a springboard to the future." And this is where the CLC started. Collaboration is one of our core values within Kier Highways. And in 2015, working alongside our supply chain, we sponsored and developed the groundbreaking BS 11000 Alliance model, which became a first across all industries, not just highways. We then became one of the first six companies worldwide to be awarded ISO 44001 on day of launch in March 2017. Each day we see the significant benefits of collaborating with our suppliers and clients. And by working as a team, we see fewer accidents with issues raised before they become problems. This teamwork means we provide a better service and experience for the travelling public and a better working environment for all, along with cost savings and less waste. So immediately after the 2017 ICW Awards, the outline plan was set. The key issues were identified along with our desired outcomes, but the most important objective was to do this with our partners by working collaboratively. Following several months of development, the CLC was launched at the House of Lords on the 31st of December 2018. And although the CLC was initiated and led by Kia, it's very much a collective of the organisations you see on the screen there. These partners include Tier 2 and Tier 3 organisations, together with clients represented by Suffolk Highways and various professional bodies. For the first time, the CLC brings together the client, the service provider, those who would traditionally be described as competitors, and the supply chain. This is a collaboration of equals, as we all sit around the same table, bringing different values, experiences, and opinions. This way, we can help shape the future of the industry and address some of the key issues of safety, customer, and delivery. To take collaboration to the next level, the board agreed a number of core objectives, and these are improvements in standardisation, where we look to raise the bar and improve the standards and standardise the way that we focus on the key industry imperatives. Learning and development to deliver a range of collaborative-based e-learning modules across staff at all levels across the Collaborative Learning Circle. Social value to give back to the community, but in a different and sustainable way. And skills gap to attract new entrants to the industry and to both future-proof the profile of our ageing staff and our workforce and fill the ongoing skills gap. We've created several working groups which bring a wide range of ideas, experiences and initiatives to the table. This collective knowledge helps shape improvements and standards which we then aim to adopt across the Collaborative Learning Circle. Safety is the first imperative we're working on, and there are currently four safety groups looking at things like supervision, plant and people interface, setting people to work and service strikes. Service strikes, for example, are a significant safety issue within the whole of the UK construction industry. There are an estimated 4 million excavations that take place each year, and 44% of these are done without detailed examination for existing underground assets. In 2017, there were 1,244 electrical strikes and 1,264 gas strikes reported to the HSC. It's important to note they were the ones that were reported, so there were many more that weren't. Within highways, our work includes the additional challenge of overhead cables, where two people are killed every year in the UK and many more injured when mechanical plant comes into contact or close proximity to overhead power lines. Our working group is focusing on all the underlying issues and root causes of service strikes, and formulating a strategy to first substantially reduce the number and then follow this by a zero strike strategy in due course. Our key learnings from many years of developing collaborative relationships were used to scope out the content for the e-learning modules. There are a range of 9 modules which are accessed through an e-learning portal. Each module takes about 30 minutes to complete and includes a short assessment to check understanding and competence at the end, where upon successful completion, a certificate is awarded. The e-learning has been approved by the CIHT and ICW and qualifies for CPD. Just to give you a flavour of what's contained within the e-learning modules. It starts with a historic view of the UK construction industry and the short-term views that were taken, with contracts often awarded on best price and little attention given to the lifetime of the asset. This short-term, lowest price focus aligns the legendary quote of John Glenn, the first US astronaut to orbit the Earth. As I hurtled through space, one thought kept crossing my mind. Every part of this capsule was supplied by the lowest bidder. These historic practices were the opposite, of course, of collaboration, with traditional contract structures largely client-based, and both client and contractor looking at, after their own self-interest. And it's no wonder that the contracts often became adversarial. We then look, the modules then look at the focus on the importance and benefits of collaboration, including detailed analysis of ISO 44001 and the 9-step process to achieve collaboration. We then move on to lean techniques, how to deal with non-collaborative behaviours, and how innovation can best work by partnering with, collaborating with partner organisations. Further modules show how collaboration can help drive the three industry imperatives of safety, customer, and delivery. And then finally, we'll look at a module on financial rewards through collaboration. We're looking to extend this further with modules on ED&I and mental health and wellbeing. I mentioned earlier the aging workforce within our industry and the huge skills gap within the UK construction industry generally, which was highlighted by the Pharma report in 2017. This review described the industry as a ticking time bomb and concluded that we needed to modernise or die. A huge list of symptoms for failure and poor performance were identified, including low productivity and margins, adversarial pricing models, lack of a collaboration and improvement culture, lack of investment in innovation, and a poor industry image. Kier estimate that the UK construction industry needs an additional 400,000 recruits each year for us to fulfil the nation's infrastructure and home building targets. So overall, there's a huge challenge for the industry. Moving on to social value, we decided we wanted to give something back to community, but in a sustainable way. The Social Value Act 2012 plays an increasing part in our bids for procurement. And in some cases, we see social value accounting for up to 20% of quality submission tenders. We recognise the need to attract new people from a wider talent pool to achieve these recruitment objectives. We came across an organisation called Onside Youth Zones, which are bringing 21st century youth provision to those areas in the UK that are in most need through poverty and deprivation. And what we're looking to do is to focus on this forgotten 25% element of Generation Z by providing a range of fundraising, employability, mentoring, and apprenticeship opportunities. This way, we not only benefit society, but we bring new talent streams into our businesses. So it's a win-win outcome. I'd just like now to spend a few minutes by showing you a couple of videos about the Onside Youth Charity.
I've witnessed our young people float around with an energy dispersed into the oblivion of nowhere to go and nothing to do. Aimless in the endless maze of boredom, loneliness, and temptation. There seems to be no way out for this lost generation, left to spend 85% of waking hours outside of education with no fire to illuminate that boundless imagination. And we wonder why 1 in 8 from low-income estates achieves average earnings as an adult. It's an insult. A social crisis, a growing virus, the likes of which we have never seen. But there is a way out, a silver lining to the dark clouds. If you are aged 8 to 19, or up to 25 with a disability, Onside is opening its doors to a brighter future. Somewhere fun, safe, and inspiring to go. Something exciting to do, a hot meal with those you know. Someone to talk to for guidance or support into your choice of employment. Someone who listens, understands, and believes in your empowerment. From state-of-the-art sports, media, dance, and musical facilities to inclusive activities for young people of all abilities. From arts and crafts to enterprising career paths to just meeting some friends and having some laughs. Giving a generation the chance and the confidence, the determination to find themselves without discrimination. Giving a generation the hunger and the drive to lead healthy, active, and aspirational lives. There are well over 20,000 young people engaged in over 20 activities a day here, 7 days a week, 52 weeks a year, and 1 in 4 come for one-to-one support. It's proven to reduce crime and antisocial behavior by half or more, as well as create hundreds of opportunities for employment. It's 21st century youth provision, built on noble and sustainable partnerships between the community, local authority, young people, and private business leadership. Without each other, none of this would happen. So let's support each other and make it happen. Help OnSide create 20 youth zones by 2020 and give young people a way out. Out.
Millions of young people's futures are limited simply because of where they are born. OnSide creates the opportunity of another path. A path away from darkness and despair towards a safer, happier life. All right.
Over here.
Oh,
you've got
your phone.
No, she's not
joking.
Stop
looking over there, looking at me, yeah? Come on, give me your phone.
Get out! Get off me! Get back out!
Calm down! Get out!
What?
How'd you end up here?
We need your help to build 100 OnSide youth zones, providing hundreds of thousands of young people with a path to that brighter life. Will you invest in Britain's future? Will you invest in OnSide?
So I guess, you know, they're pretty powerful, those videos. And I guess most of us here today are fortunate to come from stable backgrounds and good upbringings. But unfortunately, as the videos demonstrate, that's not the case for all young people. And there's some pretty, you know, harsh facts there. 3.5 million young people live in poverty in the UK. 1.6 million of those living in workless households. 1 in 8 children from low income families achieve average earnings as an adult. And 1 million are classed as NEET, so not in education, employment or training. Which of those young people, they're 5 times more likely to commit crime and 3 times more likely to suffer from depression. However, it's been proven that employer engagement makes a significant difference in this, and 4 or more employer engagements mean that they're 86% less likely to be NEET and will earn up to 18% more during their careers. A few more facts about OnSide. There's 12 youth zones currently across the UK. They originated in the Northwest, but they've opened 3 recently in and around London, which is, as you all know, is obviously needed for the amount of knife crime that's been exists well everywhere. On one of the videos, you'll have seen reference to 20 youth zones by 2020. They've now upped that to be 100 by 2030. That's the objective, so a big step change. They have a very high profile board and support, as Prince Harry is a regular visitor, opens the new youth zones. So it's got a lot of weight behind it. And you'll have seen from the video the sorts of provisions that they offer, which facility-wise are in iconic buildings, top-level facilities based on the David Lloyd standard. And they're giving young people something to purposeful in their life. These young people generally are not inherently bad. It's a case sometimes things happen where they have nothing to do, and that's what leads to them getting into difficulties. The on-site use zone is a four-way partnership between local authority, private business, community, and young people. And because business people are involved, if they ever hit any sort of cash flow situation and issue, they've got business people that make it work. They're set up as individual charities and they make this work, which is somewhat different from the sort of more public sector youth provision where if there's a blip in the budgetary situation of a local authority, for example, they may pull funding from that sort of area. In terms of the success that youth zones have experienced, here's the evidence. 91% of local businesses believe that the youth zones improve the quality of their local environment, and 84% believe it's improved safety. Police report between 50 and 77% reduction in antisocial behaviour in those communities. 84% of young people who complete the on-site get a job programme progress into further work or study. So they've really become a bedrock within the communities within which they're based. In April 2018, we had a charity ball for on-site in Warrington. It's just a short video to play here.
Tonight's about raising funds for the Onside Youth Zones and Warrington Youth Club. We're hoping that what we do is raising the awareness of the needs of the underprivileged children that Onside and Warrington Youth Club actually help. Not only can we raise funds, we can mentor, we can provide job opportunities, and we can give people hope.
They need to go and see these facilities. It is a wow factor. It's a fantastic building. And the thing that I got from Bolton Lads and Girls is actually they've got huge respect for that facility. That's not what we hear in everyday language. It's normally the young people cause chaos. Well, actually, they don't. They own it, they feel respected because you give them a brand new building. And surely that's what we should be giving them as we go on into the future.
That's where the future generation is. We need to educate them. We need to inspire them. We need to open the doorways for them people to be on the red benches in the House of Lords or actually to do something else.
In all these businesses, they're desperate for young people to work in them. So if we look after these young people now, as they get through 12, 13 and 14, when they get to working age, guess where they want to work?
I'd like you to just think about something. Everyone in this room comes from, I think, or is in a privileged position. What we've got to think about here is the kids that we're talking about helping, whether we help them with fundraising like today, whether we help them with mentoring, whether we help them with job opportunities or giving them another side of life. What we're doing is, as Hoppy said, it's not changing lives, it's saving lives.
Every penny of the donations that we were personally making was going straight to the on-site, straight to the children. And if you think for every pound that we put in there, that's another meal that we're giving for an underprivileged child out there. So that really means a lot to us.
Stand up and say, I want to be involved. And by them saying, I want to be involved, they attract other people who want to be involved. And it's a virtuous circle that is created when good people stand up and say, I want to help.
But our motto at Warrington Youth Club is inspiring young people to achieve. Every pound, every penny we have goes towards supporting young people.
This is just a beginning, and you think we've achieved stuff today, it's nothing on what we will achieve.
This isn't about changing lives, this is about saving lives.
Wow. 500 in 2,660.
T to follow that up, in April this year, a group of 28 first-time canoeists took part in the Great Glen Canoe Challenge, paddling 100 kilometres coast to coast across Scotland, including the formidable Loch Ness. I was part of this team, and it was an unbelievable experience to be part of, and we managed to raise over £85,000 for Onside.
When I was talked into it, I didn't think it would actually happen, but we're here, and it's all for a great cause, but apprehensive isn't the word.
So what else are we doing? The CLC partners aim to create up to 5,000 new apprenticeships over the next 5 years from association and engagement with Onside Youth Zones and their wider networks of local schools and colleges. If we can achieve this collective target, it will represent a social value of over £500 million. The first of the apprentices has joined the CLC network, and we're also promoting the industry to the with a wide variety of career opportunities by holding regular engagements across the Youth Zone network. The first of these was held at Wolverhampton Youth Zone, where we showcased the latest technologies and innovations from the industry, and further events are in the planning stages. Moving forward, the CLC will continue to evolve. It's still early days, and we will look to grow our partner network in due course, with the longer term intention that we pass it, the CLC, onto the wider industry. In this way, traditional competitors can be co-collaborators. And finally, I appreciate I've used a lot of video content, but just a short video here, just setting out a summary of the CLC. Thank you. Thank you.